Precision starts here. Repeatable, accurate, traceable precision. Of the hundreds of inspection tools available to us, gauge blocks are special. Now, they don't appear to do much. They just sit there with no electronics, no gears, no moving parts at all. But this isn't a fault, it's their genius. Designed to be stacked one on top of another with high reliability and precision, they're the final say in accuracy when used to measure our parts or calibrate other inspection tools. Pick a number, any number, and we can create a stack of gauge blocks to that height in increments of just 1 micron for our metric sets or 1/10 of a thou for our inch sets. Placed on a granite surface plate, our gauge blocks can be used as a reference to measure the height of a part or feature with incredible precision. Combined with a drop gauge, our gauge blocks can provide the absolute reference values that we need. Now, we will use gauge blocks along with a little trigonometry to produce perfect angles using sine bars or sine plates. With the right accessories, they can be used to create precision gauges for inside diameters, ID features as well, saving us the cost and lead times of custom ring gauges for every job. Gauge blocks provide that second opinion, the final verdict, when it comes time to verify all of our other adjustable measurement tools. And if you are new to machining, they can be a terrific tool to hone your measurement skills, making sure that we aren't pushing too hard or too lightly with our other hand measurement tools, like calipers. A good set of gauge blocks is what connects your shop to the rest of the world, making sure that 1 inch in California is the same as 1 inch in Ohio, making sure that we're all traceable back to the same outside sources. The gauge blocks that we use should be serialized and certified for accuracy to the ASME, DIN, and ISO standards. Building a stack of blocks is just one of those essential skills that every machinist is expected to master. Now, with a target height in mind, we will start by finding the block that can provide us with our correct least significant digit, our smallest value, that far right decimal value in our height. From there, we will work our way up in size from small to large, right to left, until we've created our desired height stack up. We would follow this same roadmap if assembling a stack of metric blocks. Now, we don't just stack our blocks together. We actually ring them together, like ringing our hands. This creates a strong bond that holds them firmly in place. Now, this is an amazing property of physics that is worth looking up sometime. Now, these blocks stick together perfectly, just as expected. But if two blocks don't stick to each other, they might be dirty or damaged. It's that bond between the blocks that let us know that they are clean, flat, and accurate. The mere act of ringing blocks together is kind of an in-process inspection, letting us know that everything is okay. If dirty, we can clean them with rubbing alcohol or mineral spirits. Now, it's always a good idea to wear gloves of some sort when handling expensive gauge blocks. But to be honest, I don't often wear them. I'm just too busy measuring parts. But I do take very good care of my gauge blocks and have never had a problem because I always, every time I'm done using gauge blocks, wipe them down, cover them with a light oil, wipe that oil off, and place them back in their protective boxes after each use. While we need to respect our gauge blocks, they're not fragile. They've been hardened to 63 Rockwell or better. So you're not gonna wear them out by cleaning them. Not something you have to worry about. There are 8 sets of blocks on this table, but we most likely don't need 8 sets of gauge blocks. So we've got some choices to make. These 4 are all in metric, different grades, different number of pieces per set. These 4 boxes are all in inch. So right now, for the sake of argument, let's just say that we need an inch set of gauge blocks. And then there were 4. Now, these can be split up into 2 discrete groups. There's different grades, different levels of accuracy. We have an AS1 grade and an AS0 grade. And the choice we make here is just about how much accuracy you actually need. We can expect from most gauge blocks in a set to be accurate within plus or minus 8 millionths of an inch. 8 millionths for each and every one of these gauge blocks, while a grade zero set might be accurate within plus or minus 5 millionths of an inch. For our metric sets, which we're not looking at the moment, we might be plus or minus 0.12 micron for a grade zero set, or plus or minus 0.2 micron for a grade one set. This is incredibly accurate. Now, I would use a grade AS1 if I was gonna be comparatively measuring parts on the shop floor on a daily basis. If I wanted to go further than that with more accuracy, I would go with a grade zero set that can be used to calibrate other tools. And then there were two. Now, with these sets right here that are left, you can tell right off the bat just by looking at them that this set has more pieces in it than this set. This is an 81 piece set. This is a 36 piece set. And the crazy thing about this is that they both do the exact same thing. But this one's gonna use half as many blocks to get there, which means the price, the expense for this set is gonna be much cheaper. So why go with a larger set? Here, check out this side-by-side example. Both stacks are built to 3.7889 inches tall. The one on your left is from the 81 piece set. The one on your right from the 36. With more available block choices, we can typically create most stacks with only 4 blocks using the 81 piece set, while building from the smaller set offers fewer choices and might require 5, 6, or 7 blocks in many cases. Fewer blocks in our stacks means less setup time and a slightly smaller stack up error. So what does all this mean? What would I go with? Well, for an inspection room setting, I would definitely go with the higher grade and the larger set. There's gonna be a small difference, very small difference in stack up error, but it's actually gonna take fewer blocks to get to that stack up each time, which will save you the amount of math you're doing all day long. Larger sets, higher accuracy for your inspection rooms. Now for my personal toolbox, I'm probably gonna go with the smaller set, like this 36 piece set. I can get to the exact same numbers without a problem, and this box is gonna cost me a lot less money, and it's gonna take up a lot less space in my toolbox. Well, hopefully this information has made choosing which gauge blocks are best for you a little bit easier.